Good morning, students. Today I will start with your first chapter of physics, that is called physical quantity and measurement. Before I start with the chapter, let me tell you what is physical quantity. The quantity that can be measured using numbers are called physical quantity. Under this category we have got mass that can be measured by using either a physical balance or beam balance, like temperature. They can be measured using thermometer. So such quantities are known as physical quantities. Now students, I will deal with the next topic, that is called measurement. The act of measuring something is called measurement. Suppose you go to a grocery shop to buy 1 kg of rice. What does that grocery man does? He keeps a standard weight on one of the pans of the balance that he uses, and he puts rice on other balance, and he just tries to measure. That is actually what is called measurement. Suppose you go to get milk from a milkman. What does the milkman does? He takes his own container. He dips the container in the milk and takes it out. That normally what we have in our Indian standard or locality, that is a small container made of aluminium or steel that normally can hold 250 ml of milk, that we call 250 ml of milk. This is called measurement. Student, I will deal with the next topic, that is called volume. The volume of an object is the amount of space it occupies. You can see in the book an example that has been given regarding a brick. We will try to keep a brick and a matchbox on a flat surface of a table. We will see that the brick takes more space than a matchbox. That means we can say that the brick will occupy more volume than a matchbox. Finally, I will take one more example of this. If you see a car standing on a road and a bus standing on a road, the bus will take more space than a car. From this we can come to know that the volume of the bus is more as compared to car. Now we will deal with the next topic, that is called capacity. Very often we need to go to outside to get water. Normally what do? We take a bucket. We put the bucket under a running tap water and we try to fill the bucket with water. The space available in the bucket in this context is called the capacity of. If by chance, if you take a bucket and a mug and you put the bucket under the running tap water, you will see that the bucket can hold more water as compared to jug. Therefore we say that capacity of the bucket is much more than as compared to jug. Students, now we will study about two different things. In the book it is given one, I'll tell you two different things, that is regular body and irregular body. What does the regular body means? A regular body is a body which has got definite length, breadth and height, or in other words, you can easily measure the length of the object, breadth of the object and height of the object. Thus, we can calculate the volume of a regular body by measuring the length, breadth and height. Students, now I will teach you how to convert 1 meter cube into centimeter cube. It will be very easy for me to say that 1 meter cube is equal to 10 to the power 6 centimeter cube, but how? 1 meter cube means you can see that meter cube means it is written thrice. So I will write 1 meter cube equal to 1 meter into 1 meter into 1 meter. And as you all know that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So all the meter I will change into centimeter. So you see that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter into again 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Again we will see that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Therefore we count there are 6 zeros, so we can say that 1 meter is equal to 10 to the power 6 centimeter cube. Similarly students, we can convert 1 meter cube into decimeter cube, that will be equal to 1000. 1 decimeter cube will be equal to 1000 centimeter cube, and 1 centimeter cube will be equal to 1000 millimeter cube. Students, always we don't use meter cube as the unit for measurement. When the volume is quite less, then we use unit like decimeter cube, centimeter cube. For larger volume we use meter cube, but if the quantity is very small we use decimeter cube or centimeter cube.